I mean, I'm thankful that someone got enough love to care about what I do. You got to understand, I was in an occupation where people cared about what I did, not about who I was or who I am. So you cared about who I am and how I feel. So it's quite satisfying and gratifying that people would care about your health, but I don't want them to care just because that may enable me or able me to do my job. Care because you care, because I'm a human being and life is on the line, and life is the most precious thing besides time that we possess. So I like people to care because of that. But I don't, needless to tell you, I don't want no pity party. I don't want no birthday parties. I don't want nothing to end with a party. I don't want none of that. Man, I just want to go out here and bless these kids and make sure these kids get it right on and off the field, and they have an opportunity to fulfill their dreams, man. That's what this is about. Mr. Connor, I like him. I think he tore his pec. You're talking about a kid that wants it, kid that wants to work. I just spoke to him in the weight room the other day. I said, tell me what you need to stay attached. I know you hurt. I know it's going to be a minute before you get back, but I need you attached to the team. I need you involved with the team. I need you mind, body, soul, and the mentality, because he brings a lot to the table. And I genuinely like this young man, like I do all of them, but he has a little something about him, man, that I really like. So I don't know how long he's going to be out. I don't know if he's going to be available in this season. I pray so. But I tell you what, man, this kid is there every day doing what he can possibly do, and he has a tremendous attitude. We just don't open everything on Christmas. That was coming anyway. Maybe another one coming. We ain't gonna tell you about, but we gonna be all right. Trust me, we have a plan. We have a vision. We're gonna be all right. I think we had to just make sure this gentleman, wait till this gentleman graduated, and make sure he had all of his business properly attained before he could come over and transfer. But no, that was on its way anyway, and we're proud of that. We're proud of the depth that we have offensively and defensively on those lines. And I'm happy with where we are depth-wise, offensively and defensively on those lines. It's awesome. Now, I'm gonna tell you something. Now, we probably gonna cut back with all the interviews when we start camp. So y'all get them all out you now, because I'm gonna cut back on the kids when we get started. And then everything from then on, we're gonna have to approve. Because everybody ain't everybody. We know y'all do a wonderful job, and you try to highlight and promote our kids and do a good job of it. Everybody don't have the same spirit and the same wisdom and understanding and love and appreciation for the program that y'all do. So now I have to start cutting that back, because everyone don't have good intentions for our kids. And we can't put them on every day and they just grabbing interviews, because we're gonna give them the light. We're gonna make sure the light. But from then on, when we start camp, we're gonna have to approve all the interviews that they do. Most of them are doing a wonderful job. I mean, you may not believe it, but I watch them. I watch our kids, and I want to know what they say, and I want to know how they say it. Are they articulating themselves right? If not, we're going to get them help and get them the proper resources for them to articulate themselves right and the points of our program right. But for the most part, man, I'm so proud of these young men. They're doing a great job, and you guys are doing a great job into leading them into the right questions and just not looking for wrong when right is sitting right there in front of you. I appreciate y'all, man. They really are. Some of them really love it, and some of them are. I didn't even know they had that in them. Like I didn't even know Unc had that all in him. Unc was sitting up there talking like a grown man. I ain't know Unc had all that Eddie Haskell. And Unc said, "Yeah, let's leave it to Beaver." I said, "No, wait, man, you got to be my fault." I'd like to know what's going on. And my beloved dear friend, AD Rick George, has done a wonderful job of keeping me abreast of what's all going on. But that's not my responsibility to say where we're going and what we plan on doing and what we want to do. Man, whoever you put on the schedule, I want our kids to be dominant. I want our kids to compete. I want our kids to win. So I really don't care that much about whatever it is. I know at the end of the day, it's going to be business, and Rick is going to do the best thing for the university. He always has. So I have full respect and understanding that Rick is going to do the right thing. But really, I don't care. I really
I don't
don't.
want you to misconstrue what I'm about to say. I don't want you to misinterpret what I'm about to say. I don't want you to sensationalize what I'm about to say, but I'm praying. Don't mistake that one bit. So it's no way I could be this over here and not this over here.
So the same doubt or ridicule or attack that I got when I played the game, I'm going to get that same level of coaching the game. Like, it's different levels, different devil. And I understand what levels I'm on. I've always operated differently, but I've always had some headphones on and had a beat going on in my head that no one could understand. So I don't subscribe to what everyone else does. I try to do right by these kids, and I try to put them in the best possible situations to be successful. It really, and that's so funny because I laugh every time they do it, and Neely understands it too. This is so far away from being about me, it's ridiculous. I want my kids to succeed. I want them dudes to do their thing. I want them to be top five picks, man. I want them to be draftable, all draftable. And I want to teach them how to preserve the finances. I want to teach them how to navigate through relationships. I want to teach them how to understand who's who and what's what and game, recognize game when they see game, man. That's what I want for our kids. It is so far separated from being about me. It's crazy. So when I see that, I just laugh my butt off. I really have a good time. A lot of the stuff, I laugh my butt off because it's hilarious to me, man, especially the judgmentalness of the people. And they got to understand that I do keep receipts. I keep so many receipts. First and foremost, Kevin Plank and Under Armour, man. Man, we've been together long in Georgia Wheezy. And I mean, Kevin Plank, man, you talking about love. I love this young, I love this man so much for what he's done for me, my youth programs, Truth, and just through the years when no one would help and he stepped out and he did, even with going to Jackson and changing that whole dynamic of all the sports wearing UA stuff and we can afford it. And the multiple uniforms. I think we outdid Oregon when we was at Jackson State. We had several helmets and several uniforms. I think we barely, if we did, wear the same combination twice. I don't think we did in a whole season. We may wear the same top and bottom, but not the same helmet. So we always split it up. But what he means to me and what he meant to me was tremendous. You do know Nike is a, Colorado is a Nike school. So Mr. Plank and I talk, and we spoke business-wise as well as relationally-wise, and I had to do what I had to do, and I'm ecstatic, and I'm excited about it, and just seeing some of the old shoes, and Rick and I going up to Nike, I think we went there several months ago to just see the vision and the goal of what we're trying to attain with our young man at the university. I can't give it away, give you everything that's going to transpire, but you're going to be excited when you see what's going to transpire, not only with the footwear, but with the uniforms. You're going to be excited about it. It's going to be monumental. It's going to be matched. They're going to go together like ebony and ivory, I promise you. It's going to be more. I'm trying to give you a little heat that no one has because I got love for y'all like that. It's going to be a little more, but some of the kids, few of the kids may wear my shoes this year. They may. Depending on how they playing. You know, I ain't finna do all that and you ain't doing all this. You got to be doing this before I do that. The players were for the fans as well. That's a tremendous process. I don't know when that will transpire. But one of my favorite authors, honestly, man, is John Maxwell. If you could get your hands on any John Maxwell books, do it because it's going to edify you. It's going to really take you to another level of your thought process and understanding on like the now. Like anything I do, I'm about the now. I'm not about tomorrow or the next day. I'm about now. Let's win right now. Let's dominate right now. Let's be happy right now. Let's have peace right now. Let's have joy right now. Let's exude love right now. Like why we got to wait? Because we're living in a right now society. You want your text messages right now. You want your phone calls right now. You want your food right now. And they've pretty much constructed everything to get you everything. You can sit at the crib and order something while we're talking right now. Yeah. It's a right now society. I think we just completed the last chapter, which is going to be the rest of it, I think, is already penned. I got to thing that thick. I got to read over the next several days to make sure, because it's got to be authentically me.
Florida slang and that twang.
Some of those words going to be like that, so you know it's me. It ain't going to be Dallas. It ain't
going to be no
King James version. It's going to be the hood, the HB, the hood version of everything, man. But that's what I love. That's why I got love for y'all, man. Like, you accept me for being who I am, how I am. I accept y'all for being who you are. We only change that we're trying to make is to excel, to go to the next level. But we're not trying to change the core of who you are, because who you are consequently establishes what you are and how you are. And I'm an open book whenever you want to know, because like Neely say, and it's so funny when I hear people saying some people about status is not qualified. I say, well, and Neely and I had this conversation, like, you know, when people get fired from college coaching, what do? They usually go on TV, don't they?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I think I did that for 17 years. And so,
yeah.
When people really want to know the game, they, you know, most oftentimes when they really know the game, they mean they play the game. So we getting up there. So how can you say I'm not qualified? Then the majority of the team looks like me. So don't you think I have the understanding how to communicate with them? So where am I not qualified? Then when it comes to the business side of it, that's when we really excel. Because last time I checked, we were sold out. Last time I checked, we were up several 100% in merchandising. Yeah. And last time I checked, the ratings, even on the spring game, was phenomenal. I did everything in the last decade. Last time I checked, the business side of things was really doing well, too.
A little bit.
Right. And if you're going to give us credit for nothing, at least give us credit for hiring the proper staff. The Bible says the rod and that staff, they come.
I think we know what we're doing a little bit.
Yeah.
Yeah, they got to give us credit sooner or later, but we ain't working for credit, man. We're working for these kids. Since you got here when you wanted to, I put you in when I want to. We're going to see how you play out, because they don't understand this is real to me. So when you coming back late off the break, that means you don't value this.
Rent due. Now you coming home with an old lady. She said, oh, baby, you got what? You got fired. You know we got to pay bills, right?
So now, you know, Larry around the corner with his bag, he looking real handsome right now. Now that's going to be a problem.
Yeah.
But that's how I go down. And I'm real with him like that. That's really how I go down. So we just try to teach life lessons with these young men. But I don't, if it is what it is, it is what it is, man. I don't expect y'all to sugarcoat it, man. Call it what it is. If I'm doing something stupid, check me. Like, let me know what you hear, what you see, or what it is. And I give you the why. One thing Anilia will tell you, it's always a why. I don't never do nothing off emotions, because I'm way past that lifestyle. I do stuff based off real calculated moves that I've thought through. I don't never emotionally do this or do that or say this or say that. No. A lot of times God has stopped me, because everything I say in my head, I can see. Like, I'm visual. Like, I see every darn thing I say. I can see it playing out in front of me. And sometimes I'd be in the middle of a conversation, I just stopped. And I was like, Lord, thank you. And, that's a blessing, because some things I be wanting to say to these folks, man, you have no idea.
Man, I love Malachi.
I'm not going to tell you the team, but it's a team who just called me yesterday about Malachi. And I told them the truth about Malachi. Malachi is one, first of all, Malachi, Florida boy, let's get this straight. So you know he's one of my favorites. I met Malachi and his mother when Shador was on a visit at Florida State. So I've been knowing Malachi for a long time, and Malachi was on a visit at Florida State. So I got love for him. I mean, certain things that Malachi has to work on as a young man to develop himself to be in a professional. A lot of these guys think when you go pro, you go pro. You got to, the Bible says, who finds a good wife finds a good thing. Like, you got to be a wife before, you got to be a wife before your wife. So you got to be a pro before you're a pro. You don't get to the pros then say, I'm a pro. You got to be a pro before that. And Malachi just has to work on some personal things that constitutes that he's a pro even before he makes it to the pro. Because money is only going to exemplify the weaknesses and the shortcomings that we have. Money don't cover those things. It don't shield us from those things. I've always said money makes you more of whom you really are. Understand how serious this is and the talent that he has. And if he just work on certain things about his game and life, man, that kid there
Oh my God, he has so much. Malachi probably should be in during the NBA. Let's just get this straight. If he really, really got down to it, Malachi, and that's what I told the gentleman who called me, one of the scouts. I said, go watch his basketball tape from high school and then call me back. And he said, oh my God. I said, yeah, that's the type of athlete he is. Fast discipline stuff has to match up with who he's trying to be. But I love him to life, man. I really do. I'm praying for him. And he knows that he could call me. And he Malachi knows that. All my kids that played for me, they know that from Jax.
I pray that even at media day, don't come with the foolishness where it's versus the other coaches or who said this and who said that, man, because I ain't got time for that foolishness, man. Everybody talking to everybody says something behind the curtains, and I know that. So, but I ain't, you know. I come in to win games, man. I ain't come in to accumulate friends. But I wish the best of all of them. I know a few of the coaches really well because we've had relationships. So I wish them the best, man. I don't even talk about it. No, that's the funny thing about it, man. You ain't never heard me talk about no coach unless I'm uplifting him. I mean, I think the architect and one of the greatest all time is Coach Saban, and I'm about to shoot a commercial with him. And I can't wait to do that. And within the next 2 days, we've got to be on the set and having a good time where I could glean everything that he has, because to me, he is the magna cum laude of college football. He is that. So I look forward to all these gentlemen. But as far as everybody having something to say about us, I could care less, man. I really don't. That means we on the line. That means they know we're coming.
Dr. Neely, I'm going to probably go out and do a little fishing now.
I'm Bassy Prime.
Yeah. Let me see if I can flip camera. You don't know how to do none of this stuff. Yep, there we go. I'm about to go out there and fish.
I tell you what, man, I'm better in person than Zoom, than that. I just like to get y'all in, but I'm better in person. So whenever you come, we'll try our best. I know Shiloh, you probably could get Shiloh before Shador.
Absolutely.
Shador don't do too much of nothing. Like, I really have to convince Shador of like, Shador is so locked in on what he has to do in life that he's not doing something unless it's helping him elevate to where he is. Like Shador just was invited to the Manning camp by Archie himself. And I had to tell, I said, Shador, this is a great deal. Shador said, Dad, I can't miss 2 days of practice. I got to get on the same page as my teammates, and I can't do it. So then I got a call from that family saying, well, you know, we never had anybody come late or leave early. I said, man, his priority is his team. And I apologize, you know, but that's who he is. That's how he thinks. He don't think about, hey, man, I got to go to this. Shador don't care. Like, he gets invited everywhere to do everything with a lot of people. Shador is like a worker. He's locked in. So he's a little – Shiloh is different now. Shiloh's a whole different kid. Like, Shiloh – Fridays, we locked in like a pit. We do something called 24 till, so we account for 24 hours to that kickoff. We account for that. So every second is structured on for the kids, for the young men, because, you know, family's in town, girlfriends in town, all that in town. We got to keep these guys locked in. So we 24 till. If we play at 11, that means we doing a mock walkthrough practice or run through practice at 11 that prior day. And we account for all those hours. So that's tough on Fridays. Fridays are tough. But you going to have a better chance getting Shiloh than Shador. Shiloh is going to be hilarious. He'll have a good time. Shiloh is funny, man. Shador is more direct and concrete. And when the season starts, he gets locked in. There ain't no playing with him. Like, he nearly know he is.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
It could be Shador. You know, we on ESPN this week. They're coming down to interview. Dad, come on. It's like that with him. Hey, dog, you know you got – that's part of it. You got to do that. You're coming to film. But Shador is – he's different like that. Now, Shiloh will be what do you want me to wear on that, Dad? Yeah. Shiloh, make sure my hair braided up right. That's Shiloh. Shiloh's totally different.
Right. Different.
But it's these personalities about to come out when we start camping. You'll see more of the personalities. Mm-hmm. And it's a lot of guys that you don't even know yet that they have tremendous personalities. And as we – get along in it, you're going to see the talent change where, okay, this guy's making a real run to be out there on that field or to be vital on special teams. So many darn players too, man, that so many new ones, and you guys do a great job already. I'm seeing a lot of different personalities I didn't know that they had that are good. And like I learned from what you did, I didn't know Big Fella, we called him Tank. I didn't know his name was Tank. I ain't never heard nobody call him Tank. You know, so I got an elevator. I say, so you Tank, huh?
Yeah.
I said, well, hey, I better see an armored tank. You better block somebody to keep him off my son. Let's see that. Keep on pushing, man. I can't wait to end next week and give them a little break. Then they come on back and get started with camp. But camp is going to be that's when the whole tone going to change. Then they know we start walking a little different when camp started. It's a whole different approach now. Yes, yeah. And I tell them all, as close as we get to the game, you start seeing a whole different version of me. So you better get what you like right now. Because as close as we get to that game, it's a whole nother brother in there that walks different, talks different, acts different, looks different. Like, it's a whole different guy. Yeah. We get to it.